dar aquele perspectiva on agriculture. I will present a brief paper and we will have a discussion on that thereafter. In Mahatma Gandhi's conception of Swaraj, agriculture was the cornerstone of all development. He wanted policies that would help build up agriculture and production of goods essential for the people through a network of cottage industries that would generate employment for the people. Mahatma Gandhi's model was not centralized mass production, but production by masses. And today we discussed about that. Next. Mahatma Gandhi wrote about farmers. I quote, "The farmer is the father of the world, but it is his greatness that he is not aware of the fact. Those who devote themselves to good works of any worth are not aware of their own goodness. Just as we breathe every moment but are not aware of this, aware of the fact, so are good people by their very nature impelled to give expression to their goodness. They are not conscious that they deserve any credit. They do not care to be honored." Next. A farmer cannot, another quote from Gandhi, "A farmer cannot work without applying his mind. He must be able to test the nature of his soil, must watch the changes of the weather, must know how to manipulate his plough skillfully, and be generally familiar with the movements of stars, the sun, and the moon. The farmer knows enough of astronomy, geography, and geology to serve his needs. He has to feed his children and has therefore some idea of duties of man and residing as he does in the vast open spaces of this earth. He naturally becomes aware of the greatness of God. Physically, it goes without saying, he is always sturdy. He is his own physician. Within. Thus, we can see he does not have an educated mind. To understand Gandhi's standpoint, it is necessary to remember that his thought or philosophy is based upon truth. Truth for him is God, and God never provides for tomorrow.